What did I say?
During the meanwhilest.
During the meanwhilest? No, no, not that at all.
Oh, well, hello. It's Dexter and me back on YouTube. And it only seems like last week that we were on last. Because it was only last week that we were on last, but never mind. Exciting news. This week's video is sponsored for the first time in this channel's short but oh so illustrious lifespan. We've got a video sponsor. And it's my daughter's Etsy shop. Beth and Reese Designs is sponsoring this week's video. Beth makes resin art, jewellery, pebble art, paints. So go along, have a look at her Etsy shop. Details are on the screen right now. And yeah, if you like something, then, you know, get in touch and buy it. She also does commissions and custom orders as well. So if there's anything you fancy made out of resin, let her know. And if she can do it, she'll give you a price and make it for you. What she has done is donated some stickers to give away this week. So if you'd like a During the Meanwhile Border Terrier sticker, a During the Meanwhile Tex sticker, or a Fujifilm sticker, follow the link on this channel's homepage to my Instagram account, and leave me a private message on Instagram with your details, and I'll send you a sticker of your choice. There we are. So thank you very much, Bethan, for that. It's very, very much appreciated. All right, in other news, it is my birthday tomorrow. This is 57 years of age tomorrow. Would you believe? I don't look a day over 70. Right, also, we had a bit of, over Christmas, well, on Christmas Day itself, Dexter was taken ill. He had a seizure, or what we thought at the time was a seizure. It turns out he's gluten intolerant, and gluten in his diet was causing him to have sort of like Tourette's like twitches and muscle spasms. And it caused ultimately on Christmas Day, probably the gluten combined with all the excitement he'd had of opening his presents, a seizure, poor thing. Anyway, he's fine now. We've had to change his diet. He's absolutely fine. I think I'm now, since he's changed his diet, I am actually allergic to him. I can't, you can't make it up, can you? Since his diet has changed, and he comes in and cuddles me at night, my throat gets tight, I start to cough, I get a runny nose, and my eyes start to itch. When he goes away, that stops. Don't worry, we're not going to get rid of Dexter. The family have already said that if anybody's going to go, it's going to be me, not him. And I'd go along with that, to be honest. No, I will just take some antihistamines or whatever, but I'm certainly not going to change the way I interact with my lovely little dog. But it was such a worry on Christmas Day for us, as you can imagine. But there we are. He is fine. Thank goodness he's fine. And yeah, good. Right, on to the subject of today's video, and it is shooting macro with Fujifilm, with my Fujifilm X-T3. Now, when you think macro and Fujifilm, your first thoughts turn to their excellent, excellent 80mm f2.8 lens, or their 60mm f2.4 macro lens. And at a push, perhaps, they are 16mm 1.4, which is miles away from being a macro lens, but has such close focusing capabilities. You can take sort of like pseudo macro images with it. Now, I love macro photography, absolutely love it, and I love looking at proper macro photographers' photographs. I'm no good at it myself. I just haven't got the patience to sit there and wait for an insect to come and then take, you know, 100 images and focus stack those to get some perfect back to front sharp image. I simply don't have the patience to do that, or I think, to be honest, the talent to do it. I try my best. I love macro photography, but I'm no good at it. I did have my Nikon D700 and 105mm f/2.8D lens, but the sharp-eyed amongst you will have noticed that it's not been on my shelf of late, and that's because I sold it. I know, I love that D700 camera. It's a legendary Nikon camera, and the reason that I sold it is a good one. I found myself looking at Nikon lenses online, thinking, oh, if I just get the 16-35 and, you know, the 70-200, I can do this, that, the other. And I thought, well, hang on a minute. You sold all your Nikon stuff and moved over to Fujifilm. Now, there's no way in the world I'm abandoning Fujifilm and going back to Nikon. And I thought, well, you've invested a load of money in a medium format system. Why go back and shoot full frame? And I figured the only way to stop me doing that, because you know what I'm like, once I get an idea in my head, I got to see it through. The only way to stop me doing that was to sell the camera and the lens. But with the proceeds, or part of the proceeds of that, and I got quite a good price for selling them, I bought Fujifilm's XF35mm f/2 lens. Now, this isn't a macro lens by any manner of means. It simply isn't. Its closest focal or focusing distance is 35 centimeters, and it's got a paltry, I think, 1.3 or 1.4 times magnification ratio, so it's not a macro lens. But I was missing doing macro, and yeah, you can use the 16 millimeter, but I wanted something a little bit more, so I invested in some JJC extension tubes for the princely sum of 35 quid. So I thought, you know, if they don't work, it's only £35. It's not a fortune that I've lost, but they do work and they're fantastic. Now, in the kit, you get two tubes. You get an 11 millimeter and a 16 millimeter tube, and then obviously you can combine them into a 27 millimeter tube, so it gives you it gives you three options for extending your 35mm lens. Now, what these then extensions give you is the 11mm tube on its own brings the closest focal distance down to 18 centimeters. The 16 centimeter tube on its own brings it down to 16.5 centimeters. And the 27mm tube, which is the 11 and the 16 combined, brings it down to 14 centimeters. Now, this is from the sensor. So when you've got both the tubes combined, the subject you're shooting, it's almost right in front of your front element of the lens. So you can get that close, and the results are superb, even though I say so myself. The 35mm is a sharp lens. Now, these tubes do not in any way detract from the lens's sharpness. I can't see any difference in sharpness, to be honest. But what they do bring, obviously, is a closer focal distance and a much greater, though I don't know what it is, magnification ratio. Looks like a one-to-one to me, but I don't know. You can probably find it online somewhere, but, you know, the images look well magnified to me, then put it that way. They've got pass-through contacts on them, so you can still use the autofocus capabilities of the lens, although, to be honest, when you're focusing that close to a subject, what I tend to do is switch it to manual. I set the lens to its closest focal distance and then use like the geared rail on a macro or geared head to move the camera back and forth to achieve optimum focus. And I do all that manually using Fuji's focus peaking. So I don't tend to use autofocus with it, though if you want to, it's still there and it does still work. Obviously, as soon as you've put these tubes on the lens, it's useless for pretty well anything other than close work. It will no longer focus past, you know, a foot, I would say. So it's not a fit and forget solution. If you want to use the lens normally, you've got to take the tubes back off. But that's no great sacrifice, to be honest, for the results you get. So, as I said, they were £35 from a famous internet shop, which I don't like using, but needs must sometimes. So if you enjoy the beauty that is macro photography, but don't want to invest over £1,000 in Fuji's 80mm lens, or what is it, £600-£700 in the 60mm lens, get these tubes for £35, and you can use them with any of your Fujifilm lenses then to get really quite good usable macro results. You're never going to win any awards. No, you might, to be honest, I don't know. That's a bit presumptuous of me. I'm never going to win any awards with my macro photography, put it that way. You might. These tubes, I can heartily recommend them. Anyway, that's it for this week. I'm going to get ready now to I'm going to celebrate my birthday, to be honest. I don't celebrate them anymore. I'm going to look forward to my birthday tomorrow have birthday cuddles with Dexter and battle through the sneezes and the coughs. Right. Thanks very much for watching. I hope you found this in some way useful and entertaining. Please check out Bethan's Etsy shop on Etsy, obviously. Again, I'll put her business card up now with all her links on it. So go take a look at that. And as I said at the start of the video, if you want a sticker, hop onto my Instagram, PM me, and I'll send you one. Right. Thanks very much for watching as usual. Dexter and I will see you next week with a really, really exciting video about adapting old manual focus and autofocus lenses onto your Fuji X-mount camera. And after that, because I think I've posted a video now every Saturday for about 4 months, maybe a bit longer, I'm not sure. I'm going to take a bit of a break. I'm going to have a few weeks off, recharge my batteries. Hopefully, now that I've had my COVID vaccine, the first dose at time of filming, at least, I'll be able to get out and about soon and take some pictures and make some landscape photography vlogs, which was the plan for this year, and not to make these gear related videos. Anyway, that's it. Dexter and I will see you next week. Bye bye.